Uganda, located in the midwestern area of Africa, is vital to the continent. Uganda has enough resources to feed the whole continent if these resources are used right. Education is key in this adolescent country, considering more than half the population is under the age of 15. In order to lift this country and continent out of poverty and starvation, they need educated leaders, though this is only a dream due to the current education system. Uganda, along with the rest of sub-Saharan Africa, has 31 million kids who do not go to school simply because they do not have enough classrooms. The ones that do attend school are packed into a one-room schoolhouse where they do not get an adequate education to further advance into secondary schooling. Uganda lacks in both quantity of schools and quality of education.
Building Tomorrow has made it its own mission to provide not only schoolhouses, but also a full education to the children of Uganda and all of sub-Saharan Africa. They understand it is not just about building a school, but assessing the current situation of the area, gathering support from the community, and working with the government in order to provide for the kids. They have a laid out plan that has already built 15 schools for over 4,700 students. Building Tomorrow provides the materials, the land, and the labor for the community to use, and they do not stop there. They follow up with the schools, the faculty, and the kids to make sure that everything is running smoothly. Building Tomorrow is partnered with the Clinton Global Initiative and is personally endorsed by Bill Clinton. Building Tomorrow builds more than just schools, they build community centers and give children a ticket to a better life. For our CBL project, we partnered with Building Tomorrow, and here's what we did.
Bike to Uganda is a unique, student-conceived and executed event. No matter the campus, the ultimate goal for the event is the same: to bike the distance from one's campus to Kampala, Uganda, raising money along the way to fund the construction of schools in Uganda. In its simplest form, Bike to Uganda is a stationary bike-a-thon and functions like any other charity sporting event. Participants pay a small registration fee to bike and then work to reach their own personal fundraising goals via brick sales, letter writing, and general outreach to their family and friends. Bike to Uganda is Building Tomorrow's most successful fundraiser. Since its inception, over 6,000 people have biked over 70,000 miles and raised over $115,000. 100% of the money that is raised through Bike to Uganda events across the country goes directly towards project costs associated with the construction of schools in Uganda. Campuses across the country hold this event, such as UNC, UVA, and Virginia Tech. We planned the first one here at the University of Maryland.
For our event, we had several problems as a group as a whole, mostly just with organization and communicating and motivating people to get everything done and meeting our deadlines. But, I mean, obviously we overcame that throughout the process.
And then as far as actual logistics of the event, we had several problems. So the first of many was booking location. That was really hard to do, to like find a location that was available and that could accommodate the kind of event we wanted to have. And then as it got closer to the event, like a week before, we found out that we couldn't have the bikes on the mall for several days. So we kind of had to cut our event from 3 to 1, which was definitely not what we wanted going into it, but it had to be done. And then we had to rebook a new event. This was like all the week of it. So it was very, very stressful, but we pulled it off and it ended up pretty good.
Yeah, and then at the actual event, we didn't really have any major problems. It was just that people walking by were just confused. They didn't really know who we were, so we just kind of focused on getting our name out there and what our mission is, and hopefully next year it'll be better.
Thank you.
Bikes Uganda taught me how important it is to focus on the little things. We had 8 different people. We had to give 8 different jobs. Each one had very minute details they had to work on that oftentimes were really hard to get when it came to bikes, getting the word out, getting people interested. It definitely taught me the importance of focusing on the details.
So my job, I kind of failed, even though I got to as many businesses as possible. No one said yes to me. So what I learned was perseverance and how to take no for an answer and to move on and work with what you
There were times where a lack of communication affected our group's efficiency and the efficiency of group members. So I learned that communication is one of the most important aspects of any group.
Building Tomorrow and the whole CBL experience have taught me a lot about leadership and who I am. It was amazing seeing our whole group come together and work so hard and be so passionate about something, toward something like giving money towards these schools.
So being here at the University of Maryland and being a student, we kind of take it for granted, this like awesome education that we have. So these kids in Uganda, they don't have a chance to go to like elementary school. So it's nice to be able to do this project and to just give back to people that actually really need it.
So I learned that even if you're not the team leader, you really have to be there for everyone. And if people are having trouble with their jobs, it's your job as their team member to step in and help them out with whatever you can do.
So one of the best aspects of this project was that it is really sustainable. I personally worked on establishing Building Tomorrow as an SGA recognized club on campus. So we have a constitution and bylaws and a member list, and we will definitely be having our Bike to Uganda for years to come. So it's really great that after our CBL ends, we will continue to have our event and continue to garner support and raise money for such a worthy cause. Additionally, we also participated in the Do Good Challenge and received funding for them. So we had their support throughout this process as well, and we'll definitely continue to participate in the years to come as a sustainable venture.
So this process, our group really learned a lot about community building and communities. I think what really hit home most for me is that community is not just what's surrounding us. It's not just University of Maryland and our families and our friends. It's a global community. There's so many other factors that we need to take into account. And this project, we've really been able to build communities besides our own to help better different countries and make social change. I mean, we're trying to raise this country out of third world status. So I think with this cause, we're really just helping elevate social change and changing the world. What if